GMammoth, Luke here. I'm a developer advocate at Celestia Labs, and this is a video all about erasure coding and data availability sampling. But to understand that, let's start with something simpler, this QR code. So when we're developing software, we think about common attack vectors, right? We think about MEV, we think about front running, we think about reentrancy bugs. But a QR code, it exists in the physical world and has completely different attack vectors. QR codes have to worry about rain, they have to worry about extreme heat, crumpled paper, even a dog deciding to, well, you know, right? And yet they still work, even when damaged. Have you ever wondered why? Well, here, let me show you. Start with this QR code, right? Scan it, it works. Now imagine I cut off a corner here, still works. Or bring that corner back, cut off a different corner, scan it, and still works. How does it work? Well, the answer is erasure coding, but let's talk a little bit more first. Okay, let's think for a moment how you could embed backup data into a QR code. Well, you could embed the data into the code once and then put it left and right so that if either half is damaged, you still have the data. Or maybe you want to go further. You build a giant square where you take that QR code and put it four times where each quadrant has the same data. That way, if any one quadrant is damaged, you can still reconstruct the code. Well, what happens if someone shoots a hole right through the middle, damaging all four quadrants? It's not going to work, right? Instead, with erasure coding, what we do is we weave redundant data all throughout the QR code itself. Erasure coding takes the original data and breaks it into small chunks. And then it generates redundant data using polynomial interpolation. But stick with me here, it's much easier than it seems at first. So think of your original data as points on a curve. And then with erasure coding, what we do is we generate additional points all along that same curve. That way, if some of the points are lost, like because our QR code is damaged, you only need a minimum number of points in order to reconstruct the entire curve. There are different ways to create a QR code, but generally about 25% of it can be damaged and the QR code will still work. Okay, so here's a challenge for you. Imagine I show you this QR code and I ask you to verify that it works without actually scanning it itself. What would you do? Well, since only 75% of the QR code needs to be there, we don't care if the whole QR code is there. We only need 75% of it. So what you could do is you could randomly sample a handful of points. And if you verify enough of these random points, you can be confident with a high degree of probability that the QR code is valid. The TLDR here is that a QR code can withstand a data withholding attack, meaning up to 25% of its data can be withheld and it'll still work. Just as QR codes use erasure coding to remain functional despite damage, Celestia uses the same technology to build a highly decentralized network of nodes. So in Celestia, there are three types of data availability nodes. First up, full nodes. Now full nodes, they store the entire chain. But running the full node requires significant hardware resources, which of course can limit decentralization if too few participants can afford to run one. Then we have bridge nodes. Now bridge nodes, they serve as intermediaries between the consensus network in the data availability network. They download and validate block headers, and they ensure data availability by erasure coding the blocks. There are also high hardware requirements for running a bridge node. And finally, light nodes. Light nodes verify data availability without downloading the entire chain. Instead of storing the full data, they only download block headers, and then they use data availability sampling to ensure that the underlying block data is available. But how do you verify the data is there without downloading it? Well, just as we're able to verify that QR code without actually scanning it, Celestia's light nodes do the same thing with Celestia's blocks. Here's how it works. So when data is uploaded to Celestia, Celestia erasure codes it. Basically takes that original data, adds extra rows and columns, weaving redundant data throughout. Light nodes then randomly sample small chunks of each block to check if the data is available. Then once a light node has sampled a block at least 16 times, it can ensure with a high degree of probability that the data is available. All right, that may not seem like a lot, but peep this. You actually have a greater chance of a rogue photon hitting RAM and switching a bit from 0 to 1 than you do of getting a wrong result with data availability sampling after 100 tries. Now, in addition to light nodes, we also have light clients which perform the same function, but this is the cool part. Light clients fundamentally change the scale of blockchain participation. Imagine a world where every app built on Celestia has a light client embedded inside. That means every user of every app helps verify the security of the network. And in this model, we're not just talking about thousands of clients. We're not talking about millions of clients. We're talking about billions of clients helping to verify the security of Celestia's network. Now the Lite client, it's already embedded in the Leap wallet. It's already embedded in Lumina RS. This showcases just how accessible verification can be even on mobile devices, even in browsers. And this is the vision of Celestia, a blockchain network where decentralization scales organically with participation. All right, that's it for now. Listen, when you're ready to build whatever, check below, there are docs linked. My DMs are open and you can always reach us in Discord. That's it for now, more soon. Peace out. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.